Hello and welcome to this second day of thy kingdom come. You're more than welcome to join us this evening. I'll now share with you the words for this evening's time of prayer. As you can see, the theme for today is praise. We begin by putting ourselves in right order with God. The parts we say together are in yellow. Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault, by what we have done, by what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we can respond. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth will proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. And now, this is the video reflection for today.
Helpless we were lost. Heaven sent the rescue plan of God. Through the love of Christ, we are found and born into new life. Thank you.
Now each day we'll turn to the prayer journal. So these are a few thoughts for today. Why are you cast down, O my soul, and why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God. Psalm 42, verse 11. In Christian worship, there's a lot of praise. Christians often tell how brilliant God is. What sort of God needs this? Is often the response for those who are new to a Christian faith. God must feel very insecure, they think. But we don't praise God because God needs it. We do so because we need it. When we praise God, we put ourselves in perspective. We acknowledge that God is the source and origin of everything, even the breath that we are taking right now. Without God, there is nothing. There is no one who doesn't need to know that. The way of life, which is the way of Jesus Christ, is a way of abundant and appreciative joy. Even in the darkest hours, we believe in the light and we praise him. And from the perspective of his light, we pray for others. I'm just going to lead us in a short prayer and a concluding prayer. Some of you will have heard of this before. TSP, the cooking abbreviation for teaspoon. Thanks, sorry, please. Thank you, Lord, that you are an awesome God. We see the beauty of your creation. We see your hand upon our lives. We hear of your Son and all he did for us, even on the cross. We thank you for loved ones. We thank you for all that we have, be it a little or a lost. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We're sorry, Lord, when we don't give you time each day. We don't stop to say thank you. We don't acknowledge all that you've done. And perhaps we're all too often to come to you with what we do not have, rather than give thanks for what we do. Help us, Lord, to be in a right perspective with you. And as we do so, our lives fall into place with you as the way, the truth, and the life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And please, Lord, we pray now for those five known to us. We'd love to know them, to know Jesus better. We pray, Lord, for the circumstances we're in, the challenges we face this day, the disappointments that we've had, the things that we haven't been able to achieve. And as we get ready to take our rest this night, may you be with us as we sleep. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Faithful God, help us to understand ourselves, so that even in the most difficult times, we may know your presence with us and may sing your praises, defiantly praising your goodness, even when there's so much that is wrong. This day, help us to show others the good things that we have received in Christ and show the world his way. Amen. And the collects for the evening prayer. Lighten our darkness, O Lord, we pray, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Grant, Lord, that the word which we have heard this day may so take root in our hearts, that we, living in accordance with your holy will, may ever praise and magnify your glorious name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We say the prayer that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all, evermore. Amen. Thank you for joining us this evening. I hope you're able to join us tomorrow evening and each evening as we approach Pentecost. Goodbye, God bless and keep safe.